piece of lettuce in there. All right, add some nice crunch. We're gonna put some burrito filling in there. And once again, we're gonna put some fresh salsa and a creamy herb dressing. And we're gonna roll this thing up and make a giant mess again, right? Is that what you do with burritos?
Sure.
Alright? There's your burrito. Okay? And then, of course, the other option, if you don't like burritos, just put it in a pita pocket. And it tastes really good that way, too. Okay? And those are whole wheat pita pockets from Kroger. These are the whole wheat tortilla shells. So there's a lot of options that you can do with that. But that's what the burrito filling is. And then, of course, this is just to try on the side, see what you think of it. So now that I've made you all hungry, I better let you come in. So go ahead and come through line. Okay, but on these, the squash burrito filling, I have to tell you, this recipe also said to take your raw butternut squash and chop it and peel it and put it into chunks and roast it in the oven. And I said, no way. So I'll tell you what I did. I shortcutted the recipe for you, okay? You should be very thankful. What we did is we took our squash and we cut it in half lengthwise, put it on a cookie sheet with a little bit of water, put it in the oven at 400 and baked the thing whole, okay? But since it didn't have to cook with the rice, you cook the rice separately on this recipe, there was no sense in going through all the work of chopping a raw squash if you don't have to, okay? So if you want a little bit more flavor before you put it in the oven, sprinkle a little salt and onion powder and garlic powder on it. It'll be almost as good as if you roasted it in cubes, and you don't have to put any oil that way. So it makes it lower fat. So that's the secret that we did on this. So that's the first thing you do, is you put that butternut squash in the oven, because it's going to take an hour. At the same time as you've got that bake in the oven, you cook your rice. And once again, this recipe actually does best with your short grain rice. That stickier rice gives that nice creamy texture in your burrito. If you don't have it, you can still use long grain, okay? You're not going to die. So if you have leftover rice already in the fridge, don't go cook more. You understand? So use what you've got. But you need 1.5 cups of cooked rice. However, if it's leftovers or if you're cooking it fresh. Yes?
It's like a half.
It's a half a cup of short grain brown rice cooks into 1.5 cups.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Cooked. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yeah, that's
if,
right.
If you look down on your down further in the recipe, you'll see when you put it in, it's 1.5 cups of cooked rice. So that half a cup is before it's cooked.
Okay?
Alright. So while that's cooking, that's when you can go ahead and start chopping some of your other stuff and getting things ready. But since we already have, let's see if I can find it. I theoretically have everything already in here. Let's see if it is.
What is that here?
I'll show you that too.
Okay.
All right, we're gonna work our magic and pull our baked squash out of the oven. How's that sound?
All right.
All right, there it is baked.
Yay.
All right, nice and easy. So much easier than dicing it.
Yeah.
There was no way I was dicing two recipes today. Let's see what else we got. Here's our cooked short grain brown rice versus the medium grain. You can see it's a little bit more sticky, a little bit more rounded in shape.
Short fat. That's for evidence.
That's for evidence, yeah. Can you see it over there? Okay. I'm sure I'll see it. You can see it's a little more sticky, it's not quite so fluffy. It's a shorter texture, a little more rounded. See it there? Yeah. So that's that's our cooked rice. This is 1.5 cups of cooked rice here. And this is our cooked squash. So now we got to do a little bit of chopping, right? Not much, just a little bit. What do I need to chop? Someone tell me. I'm gonna have to chop onion. What else am I gonna chop?
Two garlic cloves.
Okay. And if you look further down, there's one more thing I'm gonna have to chop.
Red pepper.
That's right. Okay. So, I have a knife here somewhere. Oh, you know what? They even packed me an apron. Maybe I should wear it. We'll be official today.
Yeah.
We have enough here, too.
I do. Thank you. You should have a cutting board, too.
You do? And a spatula.
Yeah. We missed them. All right. Anybody seen this? I've used it before.
Yeah.
The Vidalia chopper. We're gonna use it to chop our onion and our pepper and make things speed up just a little bit. So the onion, the first thing you gotta do is peel it, right? Got our onion peeled. And we're gonna chop. All right, guys. Now you know what to get to your wife for Christmas. All right. Now we're gonna. Let's see. I'm gonna do the garlic, and I should probably turn on my burner so I can get heating up, shouldn't I? We're gonna mince the garlic. I'm just gonna mince it right into the onion.
I like your garlic thing.
It is very nice.
Yours is awesome.
So two garlic cloves, is that what you said?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And I think here's what I'll do. I'm gonna put the onion here since we're gonna do it separate from the pepper. And I'm gonna go ahead and chop the red pepper. So, red pepper, we're gonna use the same chopper as we did for the onion. I should probably scoop out some of this squash so I know how much I'm putting in.
Yeah.
We need what, 1.5 cups? Is that right?
Yes.
Yep. That's already starting to steam, so it's going to be ready shortly. Once it's roasted, it comes out of the skin so nicely. It sure beats peeling it. Mm-hmm. and a half, right?
Right, yes.
Alright, I'm counting on you guys. If it turns out wrong, I know it turned out right once, right? Okay, there's 1.5 cups. Okay, our thing is hot here. So the first thing that goes in is our onion and our garlic, right?
Right.
And that's all in here. We're going to brown that for a little while. I'm going to make you all smell like you were cooking. You're going to go home and your neighbor's going to say, "Where have you been?" You know, every now and then, if you go to Kroger, these onions are making me cry. If you go to Kroger, every now and then, they actually have containers of already cubed butternut squash that will go on manager's special. Mm. When they do, grab them, because that will save you all the hard work of chopping it. And there's so many things that you can do with butternut squash. If you got it cubed up like that, raw, already peeled, ready to go, you can put your favorite seasonings on it, put it on a cookie sheet, and roast it in the oven like oven fried potatoes, only it's oven fried squash. You can also do things like this, where take one of your recipes and add some butternut squash to it so it disappears. Nobody will know they're eating it. You know, it's a great way to get more vegetables in your already everyday recipes. If you have the whole butternut squash and you cook it like this in the oven, it's also really good. You can make stuffed squash out of it. So make that like a filling out of either quinoa or rice with some onions, and at the holiday season you can put some dried cranberries in it and put that in the hole with the squash, and that is amazing. You also can do what they call twice-baked squash. You know, like twice-baked potatoes? Mm-hmm. You do it with your squash. Except it's easier than potatoes because, you know, you only have to do one, right? instead of all these little potatoes, you just cut your squash in half lengthwise, so you got two halves, and bake it, scoop it out, mix it with your seasonings. I like to put a little coconut cream in it, or you can put like a non-dairy cheese or Parmesan or that type of thing. Season it up how you like it, mix it all up, then put it back in the skin and rebake it. And those are really good. There's so many things you can do with squash. Of course, you can also do like pumpkin soup. You can use butternut squash instead of pumpkin in any pumpkin recipe. So pumpkin soup, you can do squash soup. You can do a squash curry over rice. It's amazing. This is the time of year, you know, you start with the butternut squash now, and the next month you switch to pumpkin to make the same recipe. There's so many things that you can do.
I can't wait for you to make some pumpkin. I love pumpkin.
Well, I'll have to come up with a pumpkin for next month, huh?
Okay.
Either October or November. We'll have to see when the pumpkins come out.
Did you do the pumpkin curry last year or year before last?
I think it's been 3 or 4 years since I've done it.
Well, I think Amanda was still here.
Was she? Does anyone here remember the pumpkin curry? None of you? Well, maybe I'll just have to do pumpkin curry. That'll make it easy. Pumpkin curry is really good. All right, our onions are just about done here. So what else goes in? Okay, so we gotta put our seasonings in, right? What seasonings do we have? Salt, paprika,
and cumin.
And cumin. All right. How much?
1/2 teaspoon of salt.
1/2 teaspoon of salt?
1.5. 1.5.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Okay, and then some paprika, teaspoon.
1 teaspoon paprika?
Mm-hmm.
And 1 teaspoon of cumin. Now the cumin you can do up to 2 teaspoons if you like cumin flavor. Okay? I did 1 teaspoon in there, kind of make it a little more mild. But you can put more if you like more. So it's up to you how much flavor you like. That's why it says to taste. Come around here. Okay, I don't think that wants to be on. There you go. Okay, so we're just going to brown these seasonings just a little bit. And then what goes next?
Red pepper.
All right. Now you see why I already chopped it, right?
Yeah.
Chop it before you get started, because always your other stuff will burn while you're waiting for it. And what goes next?
The squash?
Mm-hmm. I missed another ingredient.
Why?
I think you guys got a family today.
Oh, no.
We're missing the black beans.
I think it was black beans in there.
Yeah, we need the black beans in there.
Oh my gosh.
That's why you all brought your pins, right? Does anyone need a pin? Everybody has one? Okay.
How much is it?
It was one can.
One can.
So where's Shannon? Shannon, are you around here? So, I'm using 1 can of organic black beans, and you want to drain them. You don't want the liquid. And you can also rinse them if you'd like. Can you drain these from the sink? So Shannon's going to go drain them for us. While she does that, I'm going to start stirring this squash into my rice here. Doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
Christina, isn't that handle hot that you're touching now?
No. No, this is an induction stovetop, so it only heats the bottom. It doesn't heat the sides like a regular electric stove. Okay, so she drained these for me. So we're just going to put those black beans in there. That's looking really good. Mm. All right, so the last ingredient was the Daiya cheese, right?
Yeah.
There's all different kinds of cheese that you can get. Daiya is a brand name. Here, I believe you still sell Follow Your Heart, right? Here you can get the Follow Your Heart mozzarella. Do you have cheddar?
We don't have the cheddar right now.
But you have mozzarella. I use mozzarella, what you have. So the Follow Your Heart is also, they're a dairy-free cheese is what they are. So there's no milk in them. The Daiya is soy-free. The Follow Your Heart is made out of soy. So that's the two differences. This is what the Daiya looks like. You can get it at Kroger. They have it at the new Kroger here. And if they don't have it, we have it at a restaurant. You just gotta come to Whitley City. But I personally like the Follow Your Heart just as well, and it'll work just as easily in this recipe. So unless you can't have soy, that would be the only reason. But the Follow Your Heart, they have it here, and it's not on sale, so you can get 20% off if you buy it tonight. So, you know. So how much am I supposed to put in here?
Three quarters of a cup.
There's about 2 cups in a bag, so we won't be using the whole bag.
cereal.
We can guess, right?
Yeah.
I mean, who measures cheese anyway, right? Now the cheese is optional. You don't have to put it in. If you don't have any cheese and you want something economical, you can use that same cheese sauce that we used in the previous recipe, okay? And you can put that in instead. It'll give it a slightly different flavor, but it'll still be good. So that's a homemade cheese that you can use instead. The same recipe. If you can't make that cheese and you don't have any store-bought, you're going to have to leave it out entirely. You're just going to have to increase your salt and some of your seasonings and just make it taste the way you want it. But that cheese adds a nice creaminess to it, which is really good. So now all we're doing is just melting the cheese, and as soon as it's melted, this is done. It's ready to serve. The only other thing you have to do at the end is taste it and make sure you like it. If not, add more salt or add more cumin or put a little more onion powder in it or add some more cheese or whatever you need to do to doctor to make it so you like it. And of course, that salt is really good in it too. I told my mom, I said, you know, if it was me, I'd just dump the salt right in it. So what do you think? That didn't take long, did it? Oh, doesn't it? All right, it's off. We finished it. If you're still hungry, there's more. So any other questions on what we've covered?